proposed a new information management system that would run across the internet on a lot of different kinds of operating systems. And with that algorithm, he created the World Wide Web 25 years ago, this year, in March. And he then implemented the first successful communication between a hypertext transfer protocol, that HTTP, client and server, for the first time over the internet, sometime around mid-November 1989. 2004, Tim Berners-Lee was knighted by Queen Elizabeth II for his pioneering work, and then in 2012, during the opening ceremonies of the Summer Olympics that year, he was honored as the inventor of the World Wide Web. He was there in person for that, and he was working with a vintage Next, how did you call that, NEXT, or did you call it Next? Next. So he had a vintage Next computer there with him, and made a link with the London, so he used that Next computer to tweet in response to honoring of the creation of the World Wide Web. He tweeted, "This is for everyone." And that message was instantly spelled out in LCD lights attached to the chairs in the 80,000 person stadium there at the Olympics. So we don't have LCD lights here today in your chairs, but nevertheless, to advance part of our work together on the vision for broadband in our state, we're going to pause now to honor some of our own internet pioneers here in Minnesota, right here in Minnesota, the creators of MRNet, Minnesota Regional Network. And like Tim Berners-Lee, MRNet efforts were for everybody. MRNet was first formed in 1987 as an association of members that were interested in getting the internet to Minnesota. And at that time, that consisted of a 56K connection to NSFNet at the University of Illinois Champaign-Urbana. In 1991, which is our 25th anniversary that we're celebrating today, MRNet was incorporated as a nonprofit. So we're here to honor their leadership and vision and acknowledge their anniversary. MRNet's mission, when they were founded began in 1987-89, was to, quote, enhance Minnesota's academic, research, and economic environment through the use of computer and information networks. That's what they set out to do. MRNet built the telecommunications infrastructure that supported most of Minnesota's early internet services. Early on, it was based in the Supercomputer Center as a University of Minnesota project. There were six founding member organizations. They each paid annual dues of $1,000 a year to fund the work. It was staffed by volunteers. After receiving a $20,000 grant from the National Science Foundation in 1987, the company began providing internet access to a number of schools in Minnesota. And then in 1991, more funding